The bed and breakfast bill faced by London councils has gone up in leaps and bounds over the past few years. In 1981, B&B was costing ratepayers just over £4 million a year. In the last financial year, that bill stood at nearly £63 million. It cost twice as much to keep a family and even the most basic bed and breakfast than it would to provide a new council flat for them. And rising hotel rates in the capital pushed that figure even higher. Camden say they'll not house any more people from outside their area. Irish families alone landed them with an £11 million bill last year. Tower Hamlets have already won High Court backing for their refusal to house 56 families from Bangladesh. Today, Housing Minister William Waldegrave told a meeting of housing professionals in London help was on the way. Next week, the government published their plans for a new deal for those who don't want to buy their own homes or can't afford to. Out go rent controls. The government say that'll bring thousands of homes back onto the rental market. In come housing action trusts. Big council estates will be removed from local authority control for special attention. Other council tenants will be able to opt out of the present system and set up their own housing associations to run their estates. And existing housing associations will operate under new rules. They too will be free of rent controls, but they'll have to rely more on private funding.
We know the money is there if we can get the terms right in what we put in terms of grant. And we also know that in London in particular, where the pressures and costs are very high, the levels of grant will have to be higher than in other parts of the country. Last week, we nearly doubled the level of grant for the Housing Association Homeless Scheme to recognise that fact. We may have to do more in the future.
But the housing associations say even now, government aid for schemes to combat the B&B crisis is dependent on private firms being willing to match it pound for pound. Privately, they admit little of the £15 million available will be spent. They see only one answer: no strings state aid.
10 years ago, the public sector was building, between local authorities and housing associations, about 120,000 houses a year. We're still capable of building those kind of numbers of houses. This year, if we build 25,000 to 30,000 houses, we'll be lucky.
There were 25,000 people in bed and breakfast last night. What can you say to them? These are long-term plans you have. What can you do to make their life better? One delegate this morning said people with no home and no hope.
Yes, well, it's always right to get the underlying things right, because if we don't, we'll have that problem there forever. In the meantime, we have to develop further initiatives to try and relieve the immediate problems. As I say, last week we brought forward one further step. There will be more. We have to renew the initiatives we have. We have also to send the message out very clearly, and all big cities in Western Europe are having to do this now, that people shouldn't come to London under the assumption that housing will be found.